in Texarkana, and she didn't have a car or a ride to work. And so she had to get out every morning, and she would start to town, and usually somebody stopped and pick her up. And they would give her a ride on into town, and that's how she came back in the evening too. Well, my daddy came by and he saw her one morning walking, and he stopped and asked if she needed a ride. And so he drove her into town. And I guess he liked what he saw, because then he began to come every day and take her to work. And he was there when she got off work and took her home in the afternoon. So that's how they got together. My dad was one of the pioneers of Miller County, and he was well thought of in the community. He was a farmer and a rancher, and he had a grocery store in Texarkana, and he was just well known in the community, and people, when they had trouble, they would come to him, and he was always willing to help. My dad had a very good personality, and he was a whole lot like you, Craig. He liked to have fun with people, so he joked and carried on quite a bit with people.
Yes,
he had that type of personality. I don't have a lot of memories of my dad. He died when I was 7, but I remember that he gave me a spanking one time because I wouldn't take medicine that he wanted me to take. But I remember that he would take, I was sick with ear infections. And so I had to have shots every week for about 6 weeks. And he would take me to get the shot to the doctor. And then he would take me out to eat. And that was a highlight for me, because at that point in time, we didn't go to eat outside the home at all. And then the next thing I really remember the most about him was in the casket. I remember seeing him in the casket. Well, my mom was my everything, because she was all we had after Daddy died. And Mama was the one that led me to the Lord. And so that, you know, seemed like that's something that is so special that I got to have with Mama. And she always made us feel loved. And, you know, she was older when she had us. She was 38 when I was born, and she was 41 when Robert was born. And so we had an older mom and no dad. So we depended on our mom. But I tell you, she was the best mom in the world. We couldn't have had a better mom. She married at 15. She had her first child at 15. And then they moved up in Northeast Arkansas, and she got pregnant again. And when she was 17, my sister Norma was born. And Mama was there by herself. Her husband had already gone to work. And so she knew she was in labor, and there was a boy rode by on a horse, and she hollered at him that to go get the doctor, that she was, you know, gonna have a baby. And so he did. He went and brought the doctor back, but by the time the doctor got there, Norma was already born. And the doctor said, "I don't even know why you called me, because you've already taken care of this yourself." And then, of course, you know, her husband died and left her with 4 children. Joyce was 15, Norma 13, Betty was 7, and Charles was 5. And so she was left to raise those 4 children by herself, which was why she had to get out and go to work in the mornings at a grocery store. And that's how she and my daddy met. And then, you know, of course, my dad died when I was 7 and Robert was 4. So she was left again with 2 small children to raise. But I'll tell you, she was a very strong woman. Her trust was in the Lord, and she depended on Him, and He helped her raise the first 4, and then He helped her raise me and Robert. Well, Mama was in her early 30s when she became a grandmother. Of course, Joyce was born when Mama was 15. So she had a child at 18, and so Mama was pretty young. She really thought she was too young to be a grandmother, and I could certainly understand that in your early 30s. So she did not want to be called Grandma. So they decided on the word Mama Isa, M-A-M-A, and then her name was Isa Ward. And so they called her Mama Icy, but by the time you came along, it had sort of been shortened to Mom Icy. Mom Icy, and that's what y'all knew her as. We had great parents. We just wish we could have had them longer with us, but yeah, we had great parents. This is St. Michael's Hospital. I was born there November the 12th, 1943. My dad chose my name, and his first wife was named Mary Jane, and my mother was named Edna Isa, and so he wanted me named Mary Edna after his first wife and mama.
Did you like your name?
Well, as a child, not so much, because I thought I didn't want to be named after his first wife. But you know, as I got older, I'm really proud of my name. I like the name Mary, and I like Edna after Mama. And I think it made Steve so happy because, you know, Steve was like a daddy to us. And so I was named after his mother. And I think that was one reason he was always loved me so much. The first memory I have is when Robert is 3 years younger than I am. And the first memory I have was when my dad told me I had a baby brother. I remember exactly when Robert was born. Of course, I didn't know when Mama went to the hospital or anything like that, but when Daddy came home after Robert was born, he wanted me to go for a ride with him down to one of the farms. He had a pickup truck, and on the way down there, he told me that I had a baby brother. And I was so excited, and that actually is my first memory. I don't remember anything that happened before that, but I remember the day that my daddy told me that Robert was born. I had a baby brother. I've loved him all his life, and I still do, yeah. He's always been so special to me. An absolute good brother. Couldn't have a better one. Mm-hmm. I've got a great brother. I certainly do. Robert and I have been best friends for many, many years. We're standing on the place where I was raised, on Highway 82, east of Texarkana. And when I was born, I was brought home to this house that was here. It's not here anymore. And I lived here until I was 18 years old. And we had a good childhood here. There was 9 of us. Mm-hmm. There was my mother and Joyce and Steve, my brother and sister. And they had 4 boys, and so it was Larry, Jerry, Lynn, and Stevie, and then Robert and I. Well, there was actually just 2 bedrooms. There was a living room and a dining room and a kitchen and the bathroom, and then we had the sleeping porch, or on the back porch where there was a bedroom out there. But there was more than one slept in every room. I slept always with Mama in her bed. I slept with her, I guess, every night after my daddy died. I slept with my mother. And the boys were out on the back porch. We had bunk beds out there, and they slept out there. And Joyce and Steve had the front bedroom. And at one point, we had some bunk beds in the dining room. You got that many people, you have to have beds wherever there's a place. We had a bathroom from the time I was born. We had electricity from the time I was born. And we had a lot of the modern conveniences. But my dad, you know, was a visionary. And the new things that came about that he could get, he did get. So when he built that house, which it was built in 1925, there was running water, and there was the inside bathroom. And so it had some of the, you know, the modern conveniences. It's just always been home, and you know where home is. You may move a long way away, but that's still home. Well, I know that they took me to the hospital to see my dad before he died. And I was holding his hand, I wasn't but 7 years old, but I thought that he squeezed my hand. Now, I don't think anybody ever believed that, but I was talking to him, and I really thought that he squeezed my hand. And then the only other thing I remember is just when he died, Mama came home from the hospital, and Robert and I were sleeping together in a bed, and she came in there and laid down in between us, and she told us that our daddy had died. And of course, that was really sad. But that's, you know, I remember when she told us when he died. Oh, I had to do lots of chores when I was a child. I started cooking Well, I guess not long. I had to do cooking after my daddy died because, you know, Mama went to work. And I learned to cook at a very early age. And, of course, I did house cleaning and I washed dishes. I always had to wash the dishes. Now, the boys would have to, one of them clean off the table, one of them clean off the cabinets, one of them rinse, one of them dry. But I always washed them because the boys couldn't wash it good enough for it to be clean. I don't know if that was on purpose or if they really didn't. But anyway, they always wanted me to wash the dishes, but I didn't really mind. I didn't know anything but hard work, and so it wasn't like I thought that I was being mistreated or anything. It was just what I did, you know. And it really prepared me for life. So I've known how to do anything I've needed to do since, you know, I've been an adult. Well, you know, with living with, there was five boys and me, and so sometimes they had a lot of fun at my expense, but most of the time we really had a good time. They were real fun loving, and there was always a lot of laughing and teasing, and we enjoyed our time together. We really did. Christmas was always a big event for us. And Steve would get off at noon on Christmas Eve. And so when he got off work and got home, he always got a big Christmas basket from his job, and he got a bonus. And of course, Mama had been working and she was saving money too. And so when he got home that afternoon, well, Joyce and Mama and Steve went to town and they bought our Christmas. And they would get back late in the afternoon, and then we would get in there and wrap all the Christmas presents. And Christmas was a real fun time for us. Now, we didn't get elaborate gifts. A lot of times it was underwear and socks and things like that, but there was always something that you wanted. And so Christmas was a big event at our house. It was always fun. And then we always had, we had a punch. Usually it was that lime sherbet punch. And of course, Mama and Joyce had baked cakes and cookies, and we had all kind of things for Christmas. So Christmas was always fun at our house. We did have radio, but we also got one of the first TVs that came in this part of the country. And so we had TV before just about anybody out here had it. And we enjoyed watching TV, and our family liked to sing. So a lot of times we would just sing, you know, hymns and things like that, and we just had fun with just things like that. And laugh, I tell you, we would laugh at something that happened that was funny to one of us or something. But we had a lot of fun growing up. Now, there were hard times, but we still had a lot of fun. Well, one that's always told is when Joyce, my sister, put on her booties to go out in the snow so she wouldn't get her feet, wet. And the car, Steve pulled the car right up in front of the house, right in front of the steps, and Joyce had walked around. It was bread wrappers that she put around her feet, and she sort of put something around to tie it. And she was so proud of her booties. She had, you know, had such good, she was gonna keep her feet dry. We were headed to church. Well, as she went out that front door, bless her heart, that the steps were so slick, and she just slid down those steps. Wonder it hadn't really hurt her bad, but thank the good Lord it didn't. But the boys like to tell about the time that Joyce, with her booties, fell on the ice and the snow. So she said, well, I guess if it would have killed me, y'all would have really got a good laugh. Oh, that rooster was a mean rooster, and he thought he owned the place. And Stevie, I guess Stevie may have been 4 or 5 years old, I don't know, but anytime Stevie went outside, that rooster just made a beeline for him. And he would, you know, try to get Stevie. If the rooster was down at the barn and Stevie'd go out the back porch door, here that rooster would come. So that went on several times, and then Joy said, that's not gonna happen anymore. So she let the boys catch that rooster and they killed him. And so then they had a funeral for him, and they paraded around the yard singing a song, and Jerry preached the funeral. And then we had rooster and dumplings for supper that night. And it was good. Well, I think we were middle class. Now, we were poor. I mean, we had never had a lot of money, but we weren't lower class. We, we were middle class people. We always had plenty to eat. We never went without plenty of clothes, and we had everything that we needed, we had. Now, it wasn't everything we might have wanted, but I don't ever remember a time being hungry or feeling like that I was inferior to anybody by the way I dressed or anything like that. It was a beautiful place to grow up. Now, our house wasn't it was a nice big house, but it needed painting, and you know, we just couldn't always afford to do all those things that needed to be done. But it is a beautiful place.
School days, dear.
We're at Arkansas Senior High School in Texarkana, Arkansas. I graduated here in 1961. I'm a proud Razorback, but I've been in Jonesboro so many years, and our children graduated from Nettleton, and so I'm a Nettleton Raider now. But at one time, I was a real Razorback. You know, I enjoyed school. I liked school, and so I made good grades, and I had good friends. And high school, well, in fact, all my school years were really fun. I started school at Genoa Central and went 3 years there, and then we transferred to Arkansas, the Texarkana schools, and I went to Central Elementary there. And then we moved to Houston, and I went to sixth grade in Houston. And then we moved back to Texarkana, and I went to Jefferson Avenue Junior High, that's right down the street from here. We moved back to Houston, and I went to Sam Houston High School when I was in the 10th grade. And then we moved back to Texarkana, and I graduated here at Arkansas High School in 61. I made real good grades. I was always on the honor roll, and I didn't make straight A's like Gracie all the way through school because I had some B's, but I was an honor student. No, I didn't play sports. I'm not very athletic, and I was one of those that they fussed over who was going to take me rather than who would get me on their team. So, no sports for me. But I've enjoyed watching y'all play all through the years. Well, I can remember one teacher. She taught English. Her name was Mrs. Ackerman, but she was very, very strict. And that was one class that I never made an A in, because she didn't give A's. Nobody in her class got an A. She said nobody was perfect. And so it didn't matter what your grade point was, you got a B in Ms. Ackerman's class. And I guess, you know, she probably made an impact on me. Well, I wasn't as good a student as Carl and Mike, because they both made straight A's. But I was a better student than Craig, because I did make better grades than Craig did. I did graduate with honors. And I don't think Craig quite made that, but he had a lot of fun in school. So. No, I wasn't 30 in my class. But there was 236 graduated with me, and there was 3 graduated with Dad, so. Yes, definitely better student than Dale. Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely. I've seen some of his report cards, and I believe I saw a D on there one time. My mother would have killed me if I'd made a D. I wasn't popular, not like, there were just a lot of rich kids that went to this school, to Arkansas High School. And so, you know, they were the real popular kids. And I was involved in church. I sang in a girls quartet. And so my interest lay more like in church, and that's what my life sort of centered around.
I think school is gonna be great.
We're at Shiloh Memorial Baptist Church in Texarkana, Arkansas. Well, I was raised in this church. I was saved in this church when I was 8 years old, and I was baptized here. It was during a revival, and when I got up to come down to the front, I looked over to the side, and Jerry was walking down too, my He's my nephew, but we were raised together. He's like a brother. And but he was saved the same night that I was. And then we were baptized on the same Sunday. But it was, we really had a great revival. There were a lot of people saved. I think there were maybe 30 baptisms or something like that when I was baptized. And in fact, our life just revolved around the church. And we were here every time the doors opened. We were even here sometime when nobody else would show up, because we came to church all the time and loved every minute of it. It's where I had good friends, and the girls that I ran around with all went to church here. And we had a girls' quartet. We sang together. So we just got lots of good memories for me. And then it's where your dad was saved and baptized. After we married, well, then he wanted to be saved, and he was saved and baptized in this church. So it has so many good memories for me. It was very conservative, but I wouldn't say that it was just real, legalistic. Now, for that time, it just about what everybody else was, you know, and it's just a country church. So I loved it. I loved the church here. Still do. I love this church, even though I hadn't been here in probably 50-something years. But, you know, your church home always has a special place in your heart, and this will always be special to me. This is the Miller County Courthouse. I worked here in the Miller County Welfare Department, and that's where I met your dad. He gave driver's tests on the other end of the hall, and so that's how I met him, was there in the Miller County Courthouse. This office right down here at the end was the Miller County Welfare Office, and that was where I was employed, and I worked there. That's where I met Dale when I was working there. And then he gave driver's tests on the other end of the hall. So we didn't meet in the middle, but we did meet. But that's where we worked. Miss Amy Hake was the Miller County Welfare Director, and she went to church with us. And when I graduated from high school, I went to Houston and thought, you know, I might just stay down there. And Mama called, and Miss Hake had got a hold of her and wanted to know if I would come and take the test for her secretary. So, of course, you know, Mama wanted me to come home, and I did, and I took the test and got the job. I probably never would have met your dad if I'd stayed in Houston, so. There were three other girls in the office. We were all single, and we'd heard that there was a trooper that had been transferred in here, was giving driver's test. And so we decided we wanted to go down and check out the new trooper. And they sold greeting cards in the office where he gave driver's tests. So we went down and looked at the greeting cards, but that wasn't the reason we actually went. I don't think any of us bought a greeting card. We just wanted to check out the trooper. And Dale and I got into a little argument. I had just taken my driver's test just maybe 3 or 4 months before, and he was saying that that you had to have some different information, and I told him, well, I didn't believe that because I didn't have to have that. And he said, well, if I'd have given you the driver's test, you would have had to have it. We left. Well, of course, I thought he was a little arrogant, telling me that I'd have to have my birth certificate if I took a driver's test, and I knew I hadn't had to. But I guess he was right. So anyway, but he called me then and wanted to know if I would go with him. His car was at Hope, and he wanted to know if I'd ride over there with him and drive his car back, and then we could go to a movie. And that was our first date. They liked him. He came to pick me up, and so they were, you know, Mom and Joyce and Steve were in the living room there, and. And he, of course, you know, Dad has a good personality, and he's friendly. And he sat down there, and they were talking, and found out he was from Jonesboro. They asked him if he knew Harry Lansford. And he said, yeah, that his dad had bought tractors from Harry Lansford. Harry had a tractor supply place there in Jonesboro. So that sort of gave them, you know, they knew Harry, and I mean, Harry was Joyce's uncle, and he was a brother to Forrest Lansford that my mother was married to the first, you know, that was her first husband. And so after they found out that he knew Harry, and I think they got to where they may have liked Dale better than they liked me. But they just liked Dale, and he would come every Sunday afternoon. Well, of course, he was out here during the week, too. We'd go places, but after church every Sunday, he would come down and eat lunch. And so the boys would play. Of course, Dale, he was just a kid himself, and they would get out and play ball and play golf and just all kind of things like that, that they had fun. They loved Dale, and so he always just fit into our family really well. We just had one car, and so my sister would, she'd make the rounds in the afternoon and pick up everybody that worked in town. Well, I got off at 4:30, but everybody else didn't get off till 5 or 5:30 or 6. Well, she would come pick me up. Most of the time it was 5 or after before she would pick me up, and I would stand out here in front of the courthouse. And their prisoners were up in above the second or third floor. They would whistle and they would holler at me and everything. And so when your dad found out after, you know, I met him, well, he didn't like it for me standing out here. And that's the reason he offered to let me have his car, because he wasn't using it. He had the state police car. So he wanted me to take that car so I didn't have to wait out here with the prisoners. He says he never got his car back. That was true. We had our first date on November the 3rd, 61, and we married on January the 12th, 1962. So we had a long courtship. Two months. But it's lasted 60 years. Dale and I were married here at Shiloh Baptist Church in 1962. There was 7.5 inches of snow on the ground. And so, you know, a lot of the people that we had that were gonna be in our wedding weren't able to make because the snow, they were coming, some of them were coming from Little Rock, and so they just couldn't make it in the snow. So, but I guess there was probably about 50 people here. But it was, there was 7.5 inches of snow. But we got married at 7, and then we went back home, and I changed clothes, and we left, and we were moving to Little Rock. So we left here and drove to Hope, but the road was just so bad. We stopped at a motel in Hope. And we'd planned to go to Hot Springs for honeymoon, but all the roads were closed there. So we went on to Little Rock the next day. And we lived there for 6 months, and then we moved back to Texarkana, and we lived here for 2.5 years. And Carla was born in Texarkana. Carla was born here July the 20th, 1963. Weighed 7 pounds and 14 ounces. Carla was a week, I was due the 25th, and she came on the 20th, but they induced labor. But I tell you, I thought she was the prettiest little thing that I'd ever seen. She was a beautiful baby, and her daddy was so proud of her. When she was born at 2:58 in the morning, and he would just get people, they'd let you stand outside the nursery there and see the baby, and he went and just got people and brought them down, come see my baby, this is the prettiest baby you've ever seen. And he and Joyce and them would laugh about how he would drag people down there to see Carla, so. That was happy times for us. After that, we moved to Wynn, and Mike was born in Wynn. Well, it was Cross County Hospital when we lived here. We moved here in 64, and Mike was born here at this hospital on November the 23rd, 1965. I remember that I was in labor all night, and I woke Dale up, I guess around 6 or so, that morning, the next morning. I'd been in labor since the day before. And so I told him I was gonna have to go to the hospital. Well, he wanted to get up and take a shower. So he took a shower and I cooked him some oatmeal and biscuits. And he ate breakfast before we went to the hospital. And then we came over here. I guess it was probably around 6:30 or 7, and Mike was born at 4:15 that afternoon. And he weighed 9 pounds and 6 ounces, and he was 21 and a half inches long. And boy, I'm telling you, your dad was really proud. And the only thing that bothered him the whole time we were in the hospital, there wasn't another baby born, so he couldn't show off his big baby boy. So, but this hospital always means a lot to us because that's where Mike was born. We're in Wynn, Arkansas, and we lived in a house trailer, a mobile home. Here, it was on this property. It's at about where this is, where we're standing. And we lived there. We lived in Wynn for 3 years. We moved here in 64 and we left here in 67. And this is where our house trailer sat. We had a 10 by 50 mobile home with a 4 by 10 extension in the living room. And so we moved into that trailer when Carla was 13 months old and Mike was born here at Cross County Hospital. You know, it took a lot of adjusting for me because I missed my family. But I thought when we moved here, it was probably the jumping off place. I just didn't know how we could go much further. But anyway, after a little while, well, we made friends and we got involved in the church. And we just, our time here, I tell you, I really hated to leave here like I hated to leave Texarkana when we moved from here because we had made good friends and had a good church family. You just have to bloom where you're planted. You just make the life where you are, and you can make it good or you can be unhappy, and I always chose to try to be happy. And then we moved to Jonesboro, and Craig was born in Jonesboro. We're at St. Bernard's Hospital in Jonesboro. Craig was born here January the 31st, 1971. I got to the hospital about 4:30 in the morning, and he was born at 10:15. On a Sunday morning. And the only person here with Dad when Craig was born was Jerry Souter. And he was here with Dad when Craig was born. He weighed 9 pounds and 10 ounces. And he was also 21 and a half inches long. And he had red hair. And oh, we were tickled to death with that red hair. And his dad thought, man, he had finally hit the jackpot because he had a red-headed little boy, and that's what he'd always wanted. And Craig's been a joy and a pleasure. We've just enjoyed him all his life and still do. We've been married 60 years, and the Lord's been really good to us to give us that many years together. And we've had a good marriage. Being married to a policeman is not always easy because you worry so much about him and you're afraid that he's not gonna come home every time he leaves. But we made it just fine, and with the Lord's help, well, we've raised 3 wonderful children. We're so proud of our children, Carla, Mike, and Craig. And then they've given us 5 great-grandchildren, 5 grandchildren that are great. We've got Paul and Amy and Melody and Gracie and Kobe, and we're so thankful for them. And now our grandchildren are blessing us with great-grandchildren. And we've got 6 great-grandchildren that we are so proud of. We have got Elizabeth, Michael, Josh, Emmy, Reed, and Wyatt. Wyatt's just a few days old, and so we're blessed to have him join our family. We're so proud of all of our family. God's been so good to us.
What are some words of wisdom that you would like your family to know?
Well, I would just tell them that I have built my life upon the Lord, and I would hope that each one of them would too, because through all the hard times that I've had, he's always been there for me, and I never had a dad, but you know, the Bible says that God will be a father to the fatherless, and he was my father. And I always knew that. And so when hard times came, that's who I went to, was to God. And I just pray that all of y'all will do the same thing. He's always there, and he never leaves or forsakes us, and he stands with us forever.